So now you have understood the concept of Alarm Manager. Let's just see this in action. I'm going to create an application calling it My New Alarm and go to next, and I will use the minimum as 15 and empty activity and name the main activity as main activity. In this particular application, I'm going to create two buttons. One button will be starting my alarm, and this particular application will tell me that I have to stand up after a particular interval of time. I will provide the time. And once you trigger the alarm, the alarm will be triggered, and after every 15 minutes, it will be opening, and the alarm will be, after every 15 minutes, the alarm will be triggering, and it will give me the notification that you have to stand up. Or if I click on stop, the alarm will be stopped. So let's see. First, I will design a UI. I will drag and drop a text view, drag and drop a text view, and I will call it alarm demo. Alarm demo. There you go. And I will increase the size 30. And I will put two buttons here. I will call this button as start alarm. Right, and I'll create another button. I will call this alarm as this button as stop alarm. There you go. And in both the buttons, I will create on-click attribute. I will call this as start something. And the next one I will call start or stop something. Got it. Okay, so once these two have been defined, I will go press Alt and Enter and create these buttons here and create these methods here. Stop. There you go. Okay, I do know that I will be creating an alarm, alarm manager's object, and configuring alarm and then triggering it. But I need a broadcast receiver also to listen for that alarm. So for that, I'm going to create a new broadcast receiver. And inside that broadcast receiver, I will give the coding of my notification. So inside this, let me just go to others, call a broadcast receiver. I'm going to call it stand up broadcast receiver and enable and export it. And inside the on receive, this is where I will provide my notification code. So we all know how we can do the notification, how exactly we can set up our notification. So first thing I need is notification manager, my manager equals to notification dot from. This time around I cannot put this, I already have a context object here, so CTX. Next I can do is I need is notification manager, notification object itself. So notification, again I will use the compact object, my noti equals to here. Again I will use the builder object inside this class, new builder, and put the context set. Again context. Next I need to initialize my notification. I will give a text that is set title, content title. Title first, and I will call it, let's say, stand up notification. So that's my notification title, and I can give the text also by providing set content text, and I will call it, you need to stand up. And then you can give a icon to this, set small icon. I don't have my own icon, so I will use the Android.r. If you have your own, please use that. by using r.drawable. I will use the Android one only. Next is setting up the intent. Now, before I set up the intent, I need to decide that when user click on that intent, in which activity you want to transfer him to whenever he clicks on that notification. Well, for that, I'm creating a new activity. I'm going to call that activity as activity, empty activity. I'm going to call this activity stand up activity. This activity is containing nothing, but it will contain an image view. Drag and drop a image view. And as of right now, just put match parent. And I don't want this image. I will be getting my own image. So I have an image here in my downloads calling stand up. So I will copy this stand up image and paste it in my rest folder inside the drawable. Paste. Now I can always, whenever there is source compact, I can always go and use the stand up image here. So there you go. So that's the activity I want him to transfer whenever user click on the notification. So I have the activity, that's fine. Now, next, let's just create that notification first, create that intent first. Intent I1 equals to a new intent. That would be my I1, from this context is your context object, and the next activity, that the activity you want to transfer is stand up activity. Stand up activity dot class. There you go. And then you will use your pending intent, just like we use for any notification. Pending intent dot get activity. Inside this, you will put a context object. Again, we have that with context. And then you will be putting the request code. Let's just put it 0. And then you will be putting the intent I1. And the last is flag. I'm putting 0. Okay, next is configuring this pending intent to your notification. So my noti dot set content intent pd. Pd. There you go. So now your notification has been configured. One last thing I will do is my noti dot set auto cancel, so that when user interacted with your notification, after that notification goes away. Last thing is just provide it to your notification manager. Notify to your notification manager. My manager dot notify. I'm gonna give ID 1 and then your notification. My noti dot build. Great. So that's what gonna happen whenever this broadcast receiver gets called in the on receive. There will be a notification and it will turn up the notification for you. Okay, it all looks good. Great. Now, what I need is I need to make sure that this broadcast receiver listens for what kind of message. Well, we have a way to do that by going into your receiver. Inside the receiver, I can provide the behavior. All I have to do is provide what? Intent filter, isn't it? So intent filter, I'll provide that and put the action. And it's up to me with what action I want. Let's say com.lalit.myown.receiver.saver.message. Whatever you want. Just make sure that you use the same message when you fire when you trigger on this broadcast intent. Okay, that's good. If you want to put the category, you can put the category too. That is default category I want. Great. Next is you have to trigger this. You have to trigger this broadcast. But this time, I do not just want to trigger it by clicking on the button. I want Alarm Manager to trigger it. So For that purpose, first thing you need is your alarm manager object. So let me just call it my alarm manager. And how do I get the access of this? Simple, my alarm manager equals to typecast it to alarm manager and get system services alarm service. After that, all you gotta do is once you have the manager, our manager dot set repeating alarm. Okay, before you want to set the repeating alarm, you do want to get the alarm first. You do want to set the intent first, which will call that particular broadcast receiver. So intent, let me just put I1 equals to new intent, and that intent here will set an action. What kind of action you want? The same action which you just placed there. There you go. And if you want to put a category too, just pass the category. And category is your default category. Just copy this. Copy and paste it here. There you go. Okay, once you have this, all you gotta do now is alarm manager dot okay, you need, once you have this particular intent, now you need to put this in a pending intent, because you are not right away firing this intent. So I will do pending intent PD equals to pending intent dot get broadcast this time, because I want to trigger a broadcast. Again, it will have a context object. I will put this. It will have a request code. Let me just put it say 0. Or any integer value you can put. And intent, again, I1. And flag, I'm putting again 0. That's fine. Okay. Once I have pending intent, all I need is my alarm manager dot set the type of alarm you want. Let's say set a repeating alarm you want, right? And the type of alarm, that is, if it is elapsed or elapsed or your RTC. Let me just put it RTC. And when exactly you want it to trigger, let's just call it right away. I mean, the current time. So for that, system dot current mils. And after how long you want it to repeat, as of right now, let me just call it after 30 seconds, but you generally don't want to put the 30 seconds. Maybe you want to wait for 15 minutes or 30 minutes. But for our example purpose, I'm just showing you right now for 30 seconds. But you surely need to change it. Once you do that, once you set the alarm, once you set the alarm, that's it. Your alarm is set now. Whenever you are going to run this application, you click on that button, your alarm is set for next 30 seconds. After each 30 seconds, it will repeat itself and it will call which broadcast, this broadcast, and this broadcast is listening for which message, com.lalit.onReceive message. And in the Android manifest file, it's registered for this particular message. It goes into the broadcast receiver and it will show the notification to you. Okay, cool. But if I want to cancel the alarm, again, to cancel the alarm, all I need to do is, okay, I do need all these things here so that I would know that which broadcast I'm talking about. And then my manager dot cancel. Cancel what? Just put the PD, pending intent. That's it. Now let's just see and run this application. Okay, there you go. So my application is up running now. When I click on start alarm, it should start my alarm. And after a few seconds, it should give me my notification at the top. Okay, to make sure that I'm getting everything, I will put toast at different positions. I'll put the toast so that I would know that my alarm is being triggered. And let me just put toast here first. Okay, put a toast here. I will put a length as short and show. I'll copy this message and alarm stopped. And when I go back here and on receive, I will put instead of this time, it will be context. And I'll put inside receiver. Okay, fine. So as you can see, after 30 seconds, there is a notification. You can see I didn't do anything. I just started my alarm and there is a notification already popping up at the top. So see, and you when you see this notification, it's the same notification which we designed. And if you click on this notification, you have been transferred to that particular page. Right. So after every 30 seconds, you will get another notification. And because this is a repetitive alarm, so after every 30 seconds or so, you will get again the notification and you can again interact with it. So let's just run this also when you have toast. So let's just run this also when you have toast, run this application, get it here, click on start alarm, alarm is started. So when once the alarm gets started, you can see inside receiver and there is a notification there. Okay, so even if you close your application now, alarm will be there. You can interact with this notification and get transferred to that particular activity and you can close this application now, see. The application is nowhere to be found, but after a few seconds, you will be able to see another notification and a toast because you have created a set repeating alarm. Yeah, so as you can see, now there is another notification, stand up notification. So you can again interact with it. You can, you will get transferred to that activity. So you will see this notification after every 30 seconds or so, because that's what you have defined here. So that's how you actually schedule your alarm or set your alarm with the help of Alarm Manager. In the real life, this time will be more, the frequency will be minimized. You don't want the high frequency. So that's it from my side in Alarm Manager. Thank you.